Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. If you are to know more about this video solvency ratios, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today we have a topic that is solvency ratios, one of the financial statement analysis topic where we are going to learn liquidity ratios. Liquidity ratios are a part of the solvency ratios, and that is what something that we have to ponder upon at this point of time. As you can see, there are long-term debt to equity ratios, total debt to equity, debt ratios, leverage, that is on the basis of financial, not the operating one, and the proprietary ratio. Everywhere you can see that, you know, you're trying to learn the debt or the equity relation of the company, or probably the leverage, that is again the debt part, and the proprietary, again somewhere or the other it is close to the equity. So well, we are going to learn this, so let's begin. Now first of all, I want to make you learn what exactly is solvency ratio. See, solvency ratios are the ratios which are calculated to judge the financial position of the company, of the organization, from a long-term solvency point of view. So these ratios measures the firm's ability to satisfy its nothing but the long-term, you can say that, you know, the long-term obligations, and are they are closely tracked by the investors to understand and appreciate the ability of the business to meet its long-term liabilities. And basically they help them in decision making for long-term investments of the funds in the business. So you can say that accordingly, the solvency ratios are calculated for judging the so-called the financial position of the company, okay, to ascertain whether the business is financially sound to meet its long-term commitments. Now these solvency ratios, remember one thing, they are helpful because they analyze the ability of the business to pay its long-term debt. And you can say that, you know, it is the important to note there here that, you know, that the portion of the shareholders fund, and that we are talking about owner's equity, out of the total liability determines the solvency of the organization. This was the first point. Let me put down the second point. The higher, that is, the higher the shareholders funds compared to the other liabilities of the organization, the greater is going to be the solvency of the company. Now let me list down some of the solvency ratios which will be helpful to us. So we are going to start with first one, that is long-term debt to equity ratios. Now these solvency ratios formula, they basically aim to determine the amount of the so-called long-term debt of the company, okay, or the business that they have undertaken vis-a-vis the equity, and it helps them in finding the leverage in their business. So here the long-term debt includes the long-term loans, okay, so that is basically what we are talking about here, is the debentures or the long-term loans taken from the financial institutions, and equity means the shareholders funds, that is the equity share capital. Now there is another thing that is called as the preference share capital. Now preference share capital and reserves are in the form of the what we called as the retained earnings. Now the ratio also helps in identifying how much the long-term debt, okay, how much long-term debt business has raised compared to equity contribution. Okay, this was the first point of discussion. Well, let's learn the second ratio, that is total debt to equity ratio. The first one was the long-term debt. Now the solvency formula here aims to determine the amount of the total debt, which includes both here short-term and the long-term debt. Now a business that is undertaken, so equity helps in finding the total leverage of the business, and these ratios, the ratio basically helps in identifying how much the business is funded by the debt compared to equity contribution. So in nutshell, higher the ratio, higher the leverage, remember this thing, and higher the risk on account of the heavy debt obligation in the form of interest or principal payments. So on the part of the business, it is going to be. Well, let's learn the third ratio, which is known as the debt ratio. Now, these ratio aims to determine the proportion of the total assets of the company, which includes both current assets plus non-current assets, which is financed by both debt and it is financed by debt, and it helps in assessing the total leverage of the business. Higher the ratio, higher the leverage, and higher is the financial risk of the on account of the heavy debt obligation in the form of interest or principal payment on the part of the business. Okay, let's understand the next ratio, that is known as the financial leverage. Now, the financial leverage ratio, it captures the impact of the obligation, both the interest bearing and the non-interest bearing ratio. So, these ratio helps to determine how much of the business assets belong to the shareholders of the company rather than the debt holders or the creditors. So, accordingly, if the majority of the assets are funded by the equity shareholders, the business will be less leveraged compared to the majority of assets funded by debt. In that case, the business will be more leverage. So, higher the ratio, higher the leverage, higher is the financial risk on account of the heavy debt. Make this thing very clear, because these debt obligations are taken to finance the asset of the business. Let's understand the fifth ratio, which is known as the proprietary ratio. Now, what is this ratio all about? Let's understand. See, this ratio establishes the relationship between the shareholders' funds and the total assets of the business. So, it indicates the extent to which the shareholders' fund have been invested in the assets of the business. So, higher the ratio, lesser the leverage, and comparatively less the financial risk on the part of the business. Why? Because here it means that the shareholders' funds to the total assets has been invested heavily. Conversely, it can be calculated by taking the inverse of the financial leverage. Well, let me take some of the example to make you understand this in a much more claret format. Let's understand the above ratio with the help of a numerical example for a better conceptual clarity. Let's say there are two persons, let's say comparatively, or company Alpha and Beta. Okay, there are two companies operating in the same line of the business of, let's say, leather shoe business, which has furnished some of the details of the balance sheet at the end of the year. Let's try and understand them with the help of numbers. First is the common stock which they have, let's say $5,50,000, and here is $5,00,000. Then they have preferred stock which is standing at $1,50,000 and let's say $2,00,000. The other thing is part of the retained earnings, okay, which is $8,00,000 and $7,00,000, and the total equity is basically the addition of all three, which is 1.5 million and 1.4 million. Then they have the current assets, which is the first addition. Let's say the current assets is again 1 million dollar. Okay. And this as $1.7 million. This is the total current assets. And then there are long-term assets, which are standing at, let's say, this as 1.5 and this one as 1.2. So the total assets will be the addition of this, that is 3 million, and control R 2.9 million. This will be A plus B. Then there are short-term debts of the company, that is, let's say, standing at 6 lakh and let's say 1 million. And there are some of the long-term debt, which is standing at 9 lakh, 5 lakh. So the total debt comes down to 6 plus 9, that's 1.5, 15, that is 1.5 million, and here also 1.5 million. What are the most important thing here? I'll just highlight in bold: equity, total assets, and total debt from our calculation point of view. So let's calculate the first, the long-term debt to equity ratio. So our long-term debt is basically 9 lakh divided by our total equity, which is 1.5 lakh. That gives us 0.6. Just do control R and we have the answer 0.36. The next ratio is debt to equity ratio. Let's understand this one. Let's try and calculate this. Debt to equity is going to be total debt divided by the total equity, 1 and 1.07. Then we have the debt ratio, which is going to be your total debt divide by your total assets, 0.5 and 0.5. The next is the proprietary ratio. So that will be calculated as total equity of the company divide by the total assets. Control R. So based on the above ratios, we can observe that there are few interesting things that are coming into picture. Alpha company over here is having a higher long-term debt to equity ratio compared to, I'm talking about long-term debt to equity ratio compared to the beta company, but a lower total debt to equity ratio compared to the beta, which is an indication that beta company is using more of a short-term debt compared to the long-term debt. That will be more prone to the liquidity risk in case of the short-term rates move adversely. Now, both the companies are having the same level of the total debt. Okay, almost similar, the total debt ratio. However, due to the increase in the equity contribution, the alpha, you can say, alpha company is having the less financial leverage compared to the beta company. So what is the conclusion that we make out of this? Well, it must be noted that various solvency ratios discussed should not be seen in isolation, but should be considered collectively, which will help the stakeholders better understand and appreciate the importance of these ratios and make a better judgment relatively to the long-term solvency and basically the ability of the business to honor its financial commitments and continue being a value creator. I hope you have got a fantastic idea about this video, about this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining the video.